Good morning to all of you. I welcome to all for this our next session of Museums Heritage in India. And today we will see the museums in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh region. Today I welcome here our this chief guest or our speaker Abdul Adil Pareji. I most welcome to him here, and first of all I want to introduce him. परेजी ने जो है अभी तक जो आज की तारीख में एज अ रिसर्च स्कॉलर सेंटर ऑफ सेंट्रल एशियन स्टडीज एंड आर्कियोलॉजी जो यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कश्मीर में अभी वो कार्यरत है एज अ रिसर्च स्कॉलर, उन्होंने अपना मास्टर्स जो है वो हिस्ट्री में तथा उसके बाद आर्कियोलॉजी में कंप्लीट किया. उसके साथ साथ उन्होंने पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट डिप्लोमा म्यूजियोलॉजी में तथा टूरिज्म और मैनेजमेंट में भी उन्होंने कंप्लीट किया. उन्होंने अपना एमफिल जो है वो हिस्ट्री में कंप्लीट किया. फिर उसके बाद उन्होंने कई सारे और भी डिप्लोमा किए कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशन, उर्दू लैंग्वेज एंड टूरिज्म मैनेजमेंट का. और उनका जो अभी तक का जो रिसर्च एक्सपीरियंस है, उन्होंने जो प्रोजेक्ट्स कंप्लीट किए तो उसमें उन्होंने नियोलिथिक कल्चर ऑफ साउथ कश्मीर, ये उनका एमफिल का रिसर्च टॉपिक रहा. फिर उसके बाद उन्होंने एक प्रोजेक्ट कंप्लीट किया सोसाइटी हैज रिफ्लेक्टेड इन फोकलोर ऑफ कश्मीर. और उसके बाद कई सारे नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल लेवल रिसर्च जर्नल्स में और वर्कशॉप सेमिनार्स में उनके इंटरनेशनल सेमिनार्स में उनके रिसर्च पेपर्स कई सारे पब्लिश हुए हैं. उसके साथ उन्होंने जो अपना जो बुक्स उन्होंने लिखा है तो आर्कियोलॉजिकल हेरिटेज ऑफ कश्मीर प्रॉब्लम्स एंड पर्सपेक्टिव्स, ये किताब उन्होंने पब्लिश की. उसके बाद नियोलिथिक कल्चर विथ स्पेशल रेफरेंसेस टू कश्मीर, ये भी किताब उनकी अभी पब्लिश हुई है. और कई सारी किताबों में उन्होंने चैप्टर्स भी लिखे हैं, उसमें कई सारी किताबें हैं जैसे आर्कियो हेरिटेज टूरिज्म इन कश्मीर एन अप्रोच टू डिसमेट्रिक हिस्ट्री, फिर उसके बाद डेवलपिंग श्रीनगर एज हेरिटेज सिटी. तो इस तरह से और भी कई सारी किताबें उन्होंने जिसमें अपने चैप्टर्स लिखे हुए हैं. उन्होंने अपना जो अभी तक जो वर्क किया है तो उसमें अगर हम देखा जाए तो एज अ रिसोर्स पर्सन फॉर टीचर ट्रेनिंग इन सोशल साइंसेस एट डायट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ जम्मू कश्मीर में उन्होंने कार्य किया. ही वॉज ऑल्सो वर्किंग एज अ टीचर फॉर हाई स्कूल, देन वर्किंग एज द लेक्चरर फॉर हिस्ट्री इन गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज शोपेन, एंड देन वर्क एज अ काउंसिलर इन इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी. ही वॉज ऑल्सो पार्टिसिपेटेड इन डिफरेंट एक्सकर्वेशंस एंड एक्सप्लोरेशंस कंडक्टेड बाय यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कश्मीर एंड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ सिडनी ऑस्ट्रेलिया. सो आई मोस्ट वेलकम टू हियर अब्दुल अदिल परेजी एंड आई रिक्वेस्ट टू हिम फॉर टू स्टार्ट आवर टूडेज सेशन. Yes, please.
Good morning, all. Let me first of all, as Bobade sir has introduced me, thank you very much for my introduction there. I think I am, my voice is reaching to you and I am very much good audible to you.
Yes, yes, it's too good and presentation is also good.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. So thank you all participants. I think I should start my presentation with the note that actually this presentation is not a detailed survey or detailed description and discussion about the museums of Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh. But this discussion, this presentation is just an introduction to these museums, because if I am going in detail and discussing everything in those museums, it will take 2-3 more long hours. And since we are short of time and we have only an hour in which I have to finish my presentation, so with this I start my presentation, that is in this course Museum Heritage in India. My topic museums in Jammu and Kashmir is in which I am going to introduce the different collections and different stages of the museums that have taken place in that have been established in the erstwhile state of Jammu and Kashmir. Since you know that state of Jammu and Kashmir, which was since a few months back a state, has been turned out into and divided into two union territories. These two union territories are based over three different regions, which are different historically, culturally, and they are very much diverse geographically as well. Whole region is the people living in these three regions, that is in Jammu, Kashmir, and Ladakh. They have different languages, they speak different dialects, and they have different, they follow different religions, and there are different ethnic groups residing in these three regions. So it is very much clear that the three regions are very much different, and their historicity and their cultural background is also diverse. Therefore, all the three regions exhibit different or diverse cultural culture and heritage character. You can see in the map here that the different three regions, provinces within the two union territories are located here. You can see the Kashmir Valley. Then in the south, you have Jammu region. And in the eastern side, we have Ladakh. Let me start my discussion about the museums of Jammu, Kashmir, and Ladakh. One way of learning about the rich culture, heritage, and illustrious past of Jammu, Kashmir, and Ladakh is visiting its museums. Because a special feature about the famous museums in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh is that most of them were once palaces, which were used as residential structures and residential quarters by the royal families before the foundation of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which were later on converted to the museums. So along with a rich collection of artifacts and other heritage items, it is their structure, the structure of the museum buildings, that attracts the admiration of the visitors and the tourists and the heritage lovers. Let me start in the museums, the discussion about the museums of Jammu region first. So I am going to take the museums separately in the three provinces, that is starting with the museums in the Jammu region. As you know that Jammu once was a princely state before 1947, and it is very much famous for the forts, palaces, and temples, and it is diverse and rich cultural heritage and history. There are six famous museums in the region that I am going to introduce before you here. These museums display not only history and culture of the region, but also impart knowledge about the civilization of the past and present, and adds the glimpses of the future as well. So you can go through the a journey of history, starting with the past and going through the present, and there you will be having some glimpses of future. The culture of future, the people practicing, they have the present culture, following the present culture. You can also have some glimpses in these museums if you are visiting. So the nature of these museums is manifold and exhibit the richness of natural and cultural heritage of the region. Not only the culture, but we can also have some glimpses of natural heritage in these museums as well. The six museums of the Jammu region only include the Amar Mahal Palace Museum, Dogra Art Museum, Wadia Museum of Natural History, Buddhist Heritage Site at Amran Akhnoor, which is an open museum, Kala Kendra Jammu, and Baghe Bahu Aquarium. There are small museums as well in the city, but these are the famous museums that we should know about. Here you can see the building of the Amar Mahal Palace and Museum, which is located in the Jammu region. This building, you can see the architecture, you can have glimpses, you can have the different architectural style, you can look into it, that how it is different from the Aboriginal architecture of the region. The features of this this palace as well as museum, palace cum museum, is that it is a palace in Jammu which has been now converted into a museum. It looks majestic from outside with its red sandstone structure and stands on a hillock overlooking the Tavi River Valley in Jammu region. It was built in 19th century for Raja Amar Singh of Dogra dynasty, who was a Dogra king, by a French architect in 1890s on the lines of French chateau, that is French palace. The palace was donated to Hari Tara Charitable Trust by Karan Singh, who is son of Raja Amar Singh, and he donated it to the trust for use as a museum. It has many exhibits, including a gold throne weighing about 120 kg of pure gold. You can have Pahari miniature and Kangra miniature paintings there, and many rare art collections in the museum. This is the view of inside the museum, that how it looks, how have been the curation done within the museum at Amar Palace Museum. So if we discuss the collections there, in the first and second floor, a few chambers house a library, which has a collection of rare antique books, which are more than 25,000, and they cover the different topics, different subjects on religion, philosophy, and political science, as well as fiction. This museum houses several rich exhibits, including paintings by modern painters, like famous painters like M.F. Hussain, J. Swaminathan, G.R. Santosh, Bikash Bhattacharya, Ram Kumar, Lakshman Pai, etc. And besides that, one can have glimpses of Pahari style paintings, the hill style paintings, the hill school of paintings that is the local school of paintings there. The paintings depict major events from the Mahabharata and are also on display in this museum. In one of the galleries, paintings of Hindu epic stories such as story of Nala Damayanti, which is a set of 47 miniature paintings, are depicted in one of the galleries, art galleries in the Amar Palace Museum. Also, modern version of the Dasha Avatara paintings, in it, 10 avatars of Hindu god Vishnu, are also displayed in a separate antechamber in the museum. These are unusual modern art set of paintings and very beautifully displayed there. Also, family portraits of the Dogra rulers of Jammu and Kashmir are on display in the Darbar Hall at the entrance gallery in the museum. An exclusive chamber in the museum, once the living quarters of the Maharani, later called the Maharaj Mata, and who was Tara Devi. It is conserved. She was the queen of Dogra dynasty and the wife of Maharaja Hari Singh, last Maharaja of Jammu and Kashmir. It is so there are some things that have been, which are associated with her, and they have been displayed there. It is conserved and exhibited in its original form, where a silver bedspread, period furniture, photographs, the decoration of the crown of India, which have been presented to her in 1945, which is her personal collection, and her personal clothing and the unique Victorian bathroom are on display too in the museum. Here you can have glimpses of some of the paintings that have been displayed there. These are modern paintings of Dasha Avatara, or 10 avatars of Vishnu. You can see the three paintings. One is Matsya, second is Rama, and third, the painting of Kalki. Again, you can have Pahari miniature paintings which have been displayed there. So one painting is there for you to have look over it. And you, on the other side, you can see 120 kg golden throne that is also in the display in the Amar Palace Museum of Jammu. Second important museum is the Dogra Art Museum in the region of Jammu. Dogra Art Museum Jammu, it was previously known as Dogra Art Gallery, is a museum of Dogra cultural heritage, which is the local cultural heritage, local culture of Jammu region, Dogra culture. It is housed in the Pink Hall of Mubarak Mandi Complex, Jammu, which was established in 18th century and its foundation was laid in April 1954. Actually, the Mubarak Mandi Complex is a palace of Dogra Palace, which was residential quarters of the royal family. Then the that was established in 18th century, but the museum, it was converted to museum and one part of it was donated for museum in April 1954. It was Dogra, this Dogra Art Museum, Jammu is a government museum and the biggest in Jammu region, since it is managed and governed, administered by the government of Jammu and Kashmir, the Directorate of archives, museums and archaeology and Ministry of Tourism and Culture, which was which is not there now. And so it is under the direction of Department of Directorate of Archives, Archaeology and Museums of Jammu and Kashmir now. The museum building was erected in commemoration of the visit of British monarch Edward VII when he came to Jammu as the prince as the Prince of Wales in 1875. So this museum was actually raised in the commemoration, in the memory of the visit of British monarch in 1875. Here you can see the part of Mubarak Mandi Palace in which Dogra Art Museum has been kept, and there are different collections there in the museum. The museum has a collection of 7,216 objects of historical and cultural importance. Among the collections are the Rasmanjari series of famed Basholi miniature paintings. And this school of miniature paintings, that is Basholi miniature paintings, is very much famous in the region and outside the region, and also internationally. Some rare manuscripts like beautifully illustrated Shahnama and Sikandarnama in Persian are also in the display in the Dogra Art Museum. Also, we can see the Kushana period terracotta heads from which have been got from the excavations at Akhnur. We have also this in the display, the sculptures, numismatics belonging to different periods and have association with the different kings, manuscripts in different languages, Dogra costumes, jewelry, arms and armors, metal objects and artifacts related to decorative art, and also we have a good public library within the museum, which contains a good collection of rare books. The intricately decorated marble jarokhas in the building with inlaid work of semi-precious stones in the marble hall further embellishes the charisma of the museum collection. So building is also in itself a heritage. However, what the museum is known all over for is the Pahari miniature paintings from Basholi, a gold-plated bow belonging to Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan, and a stone plate with inscriptions in Takri script are among some of the most prized possessions of the museum in the display at the Dogra Art Museum. Since the museum is Dogra Art Museum is housed in Mubarak Mandi Complex, which is actually the palace, that is why I have I think that it is very much important that I should discuss about, give you some of the information about the Mubarak Mandi complex, which is it's in itself a heritage. Mubarak Mandi is a palace in Jammu, India. The palace was the royal residence of then Maharaja of Jammu and Kashmir from the Dogra dynasty. It was their main seat till 1925, when Maharaja Hari Singh moved to the Hari Nivas Palace in the northern part of Jammu. The palace is located in the heart of old walled city of Jammu and overlooks the Tawi River. The oldest building of the complex dates back to 1824. Successive Maharajas added to the complex in size and building took more than 150 years. The architecture is a mix of Rajasthani architecture and European Baroque and Mughal styles. So it is the synthesis of various architectures that has resulted in the in this in an architectural site of Mubarak Mandi complex. The complex is grouped around several courtyards and includes various buildings and palaces like the Darbar Hall complex, the Pink Palace, Royal Royal Courts buildings, Gol Ghar complex, Nawa Mahal, Rani Charak Palace, Hawa Mahal, the Toshkhana Palace, and the Sheesh Mahal. The halls are and galleries of the palace were used for official functions and ceremonies. You can here see the Mubarak Mandi Palace complex. The various pictures are there from the different views. Now it is in the shambles, it is in the ruins because of less concern from the concerned department. Nowadays, sections of palace have housed different government departments, government offices, courts, and the Dogra Art Museum also, about which I have talked. However, other parts of the palace are in ruins, as the palace has more than 36 times has been the victim of fires, and furthermore, the building suffered from earthquakes in 1980s and 2005. The Dogra Art Museum, which is situated within the Pink Hall of the Mubarak Mandi Palace, it has a rich collection containing miniature paintings about which we have talked and various styles of the different paintings of the region. The miniatures belong to the Kangra. It also has a gold painted bow.
अदिल जी आपकी आवाज जो है म्यूट हो चुकी है, आपकी आवाज म्यूट हो चुकी है, अनम्यूट कीजिए। अब्दुल अदिल आवाज म्यूट हो चुकी है, कृपया अनम्यूट कीजिए। ओके वेट फॉर मिनट, आई विल कॉल हिम। He will join within 1 minute. Yes, now okay. आपकी आवाज सुनाई नहीं दे रही है, आपका प्रेजेंटेशन दिखाई दे रहा है मगर आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है। कृपया खुद को अनम्यूट कीजिए, अनम्यूट कीजिए।
हेलो सर,
प्रेजेंट। हाँ नाउ ओके, नाउ नाउ ओके, यस
ओके, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू
जी।
1 मिनट सर, आई विल गो फॉर द प्रेजेंटेशन अगेन।
नो प्रॉब्लम, यस प्लीज।
सर, इज इट विजिबल नाउ एंड एम आई ऑडिबल नाउ?
Yes, it's okay.
Okay. Sorry for the disruption. I am extremely sorry for this technical glitch.
No,
So I
no
was
problem. Yes,
talking
please.
about the third museum in the Jammu region, that is Wadia Museum of Natural History. Wadia Museum of Natural History has been established in the University of Jammu, and it has been named after the famous Indian geologist, Professor D.N. Wadia. The museum houses the various types of rocks depicting the geological history of the region. Various plant and animal fossils are also in the display. The photo gallery exhibiting images and photos of rare species of insects, birds, and animals are also in the display in the Wadia Museum of Natural History. So this is the building of the museum in the Jammu University. These are the some of the things that have been kept in the display in the museum. You can see the fossils there. You can see the different rocks there, which are depicting the geological history of the region, geological heritage of the region. One more museum in the region is Buddhist Heritage Site at Amran, Akhnoor. It is an on-site open museum displaying the Buddhist period heritage. There is an ancient Buddhist monastery on the banks of River Chenab as a pilgrimage site. There is a small museum showcasing the history of the site along with the old coins and utensils. Besides, there are Kushan coins, terracotta beads and figurines. Terracotta statue of King Kanishka of Kushan dynasty dating 1st to 4th century CE is also in the display. The site exhibits pre-Kushan period, Kushan period, Gupta period and post-Gupta period settlement remains in this on-site open museum at Amran, Akhnoor. You can have the glimpse of some of the images of this open museum at Akhnoor, and you can see the ruins of ancient Buddhist site there. There are a number of structures, particularly the monastery. One more museum in the Jammu region is Kala Kendra Jammu. Under the auspices of Directorate of Libraries, Archives and Museums, Jammu Development Authority, Academy of Art, Culture and Languages, the Kala Kendra was established in 2005. It is the center of exhibiting modern art, Dogra Chitrakala, and organize international conferences within the museum premises, seminars and workshops as well, for promoting visual, vocal and performing arts of the region. In addition to it, regular handicrafts and handloom sales are a part of its activities, and the museum has number of paintings, sculptures, crafts that have been put on the display in the Kala Kendra Jammu. You can see here the building of the Kala Kendra Jammu museum. One more museum in the which has been established recently is Baghe Bahu Aquarium. It is near the Baghe Bahu Fort, and it is the largest underground aquarium in Indian subcontinent that houses an amazing collection of exotic marine life as natural heritage. It consists of 24 aquarium caves, wherein two large caves have marine fishes, 13 smaller ones have freshwater fishes, 9 medium-sized caves have both marine as well as freshwater fishes in the display. The aquarium displays around 400 varieties of freshwater and marine fishes. This museum consists of a public gallery, a multimedia conference hall, state-of-art equipment, and also a laboratory there. This is the building which have been constructed for it in the face in the shape of a fish. The entry is from the in the side of mouth, and the exit is in the side of tail. Now, talking about the museums of Kashmir region. As you know, the historical revelations of Kashmir are beautifully displayed in its museums. This state boosts the rich heritage laden with nobility of its various rulers and deep impact of invaders since long time. Here we shall be dealing with four famous splendid museums in the Valley of Kashmir, showcasing the rich heritage and glorious past of the region. These four museums include the SPS Museum, Srinagar, the Central Asian Museum, University of Kashmir, the Miras Mahal Museum in Sopore, Kanchanjunga Museum in Gulmarg. Talking about the first museum, that is the Sri Pratap Singh Museum or SPS Museum, Srinagar. The SPS Museum, Srinagar was established in 1898 in the Maharaja Pratap Singh's summer guest house, largely based on collections transferred from his Toshkhana. Approximately 80,000 artifacts and objects covering various subjects like archaeology, numismatics, and decorative art, arms and armory, paintings, textiles, etc. are housed in the museum. The detailed quantity of the artifacts in the museum can be seen here in this table. There are a number of sculptures, which is about 2,000. There are paintings, real paintings, which are about 700. There are various manuscripts, which are 2,400 almost. We have weapons there. We have textile items there. We have anthropology and ethnographic items there. We have natural history heritage items there. We have also decorative art items there. We have a good collection of numismatic items there in the form of coins. We have also the geology and mineral items there in the display. We have also jewelry items in the museum in Srinagar. One can also see the antiquities since prehistoric times to our early historic times, which include terracotta, stone, bronze images, ancient and rare Buddhist and Hindu and Muslim manuscripts. In addition to other secular literature, there are also coins, paintings, ornamentation, and different attires, cultural and traditional attires, weapons and tools in the display in the SPS Museum. Here you can see the old and new building. First, in this image, this is the old building, which was actually the palace and residential palace of Dogra Maharaja. Then this is the present building. This is the new building that have been inaugurated 2 years before. And this have been built using new technology for the preservation and conservation of the rare artifacts of SPS Museum. These are some of the collections that are in the display. You can see the stone sculptures there. We have also these, you have ethnic, ethnographical, this collection is there. We have a small single stone temple there in the display. We have natural heritage in the display in the form of these birds, which have been reconstituted. We have different saddles in the display in the museum. We have also in the display different paintings, which are very rare. Also, the stone sculpture is in abundance there. Also, the different manuscripts, terracotta plaques, we have coinage, we have bronze sculptures in the display also in the SPS Museum. Now, talking about one more museum in the Kashmir region, that is the Central Asian Museum. This museum is actually, you can see the building, this is actually the Allama Iqbal Library of University of Kashmir, and in the first floor of this library, in the big hall, the Central Asian Museum has been housed. The Central Asian Museum of University of Kashmir, under the auspices of the Center of Central Asian Studies, was established in 1980 with the aim to house artifacts related to Central Asia, including Kashmir, so that a general view of region is presented visually. Accordingly, artifacts and art objects like sculptures, terracotta, coins, textile items, ethnographical articles, manuscripts, etc. are being collected and displayed in the galleries of the museum. However, since August 2017, the role of museum diversified and increased it with the opening of postgraduate program of archaeology in the center. Besides its usual public outreach, the museum functions as the center of learning and teaching culture, disseminating knowledge of visual, history, art, material culture, and archaeological methods. The Central Asian Museum deals with antiquities of multicultural societies that play an important role in integrating various groups together. Now, having a look over the artifacts and art objects in the display in the different galleries of the Central Asian Museum, which includes sculptures, terracotta items, coins, textile items, ethnographical articles, manuscripts that have been collected and displayed in different galleries of the museums. And this is the detail. We have prehistoric tools and fossils there. We have sculptures there, which are in the stone, bronze, and wood also. We have terracotta items there in the form of tiles, figures, and different items also. We have carpets in the display there, traditional carpets that are in also silk and woolen carpets. We have shawls and dresses or textiles in this museum there, belonging to different countries of Central Asia and Kashmir, which are in Kani, Pashmina, Mughal, Kashmiri, and Central Asian art. We have also different manuscripts, which include Gilgit Birchbark manuscript, which is very rare. Kashmir and Kashmiri manuscripts are there. Mughal manuscripts are in the display too. We have different types of paintings there in watercolor that are, they belong to Gilgit, Kashmir, and Tanka. We have also different metalware and tableware there in the different metals, that in silver, copper, and others. We have coins in gold, silver, and copper. We have ethnographic items there, which reflect the art and culture of different regions of Central Asia. We have also human burial that have been taken from Neolithic period from Burzahom. We have also photographs in good number there. Some of these displays you can see here in the center of Central Asian Museum. We have dresses there, we have manuscripts, we have portraits. Now, talking about one more museum of Kashmir region is the Miras Mahal Museum. Miras Mahal Museum, you can see a lady posing before a building of Miras Mahal Museum. She is actually the curator of this museum. She is actually the founder of this museum. And when we talk about the Miras Mahal Museum, the Heritage Mahal Museum, we can say the curator of the Kashmir's first and only private museum, Miras Mahal, was Atika Banu. And Atika Banu, she was a renowned educationist, heritage activist of Northern Kashmir's Sopore town. The Miras Mahal displays a rich and impressive collection of more than 3,000 artifacts and objects, including old ornaments, paper mache objects, coins, traditional dresses and utensils, rare manuscripts in various languages, sculptures, woodworks, prehistoric artifacts, etc. However, there is a problem that due to lack of funding, since it is a private museum, so they don't have any funding, and it is founder Atika Ji, she has also passed away. So there is lack of funding and also professional curator or professional director who would have managed the museum. So because of their absence, because of lack of funding, the museum is in very bad condition, and it requires the attention of the authorities. Since it is in bad condition, there is no attention has been being given to this the rare collection is within this building. We can say that these rare collections are in stage of destruction forever if not managed very soon. Here you can see some of the collections within the museum Miras Mahal. Because it is a personal museum, it is a private museum, so there will be the defects in the professional curation. Here you can see also some of the thing is that is the traditional pottery items are there, woodworks are there, and different gadgets of past are there in the display. Now moving to fourth important museum in the Kashmir region is the Kanchenjunga Museum in Gulmarg. Since this museum is located in the picturesque and beautiful valley of Gulmarg within the big mountains, it is an army warfare museum in Gulmarg located within high altitude warfare school of Indian Army. Here various tools and equipment used by military since 1947 for mountain climbing and mountaineering are displayed also. It was set up in memory of Indian Army's first summit to Kanchenjunga in 1997, and that is why it has been named as Kanchenjunga Museum. All other successful expeditions, including the one to Mount Everest, are also displayed in this museum. There are two sand models separately prepared for each expedition, along with equipment used to scale the heights of Himalayas by military personnel over the years. For the young breed of soldiers, it instills confidence to cross the toughest terrains of valley, including glaciers, ridges, and streams. Now discussing about the museums in Ladakh region. Here I am going to discuss the five important museums of the Ladakh and Leh region besides many small museums. The main museum of the attraction are Munshi Aziz Bhatt Museum of Central Asia and Kargil Trade Artifacts, Stock Palace Museum, Hall of Fame Museum, Balti Heritage House and Museum, Textile Museum of Ladakh. Talking about the Munshi Aziz Bhatt Museum of Central Asia and Kargil Trade Artifacts, the museum has been operational since 2004, owned and maintained by two brothers. It is also a private museum, and that is why it is being managed and maintained by the sons of its founder, that is Aziz Bhatt, and the two brothers who manage now are Gulzar Hussain Munshi, who is the director of museum, and Ejaz Hussain Museum, who is the curator of museum. With the assistance from their family members and founding partners, International Association for Ladakh Studies. The museum is named after the ancient Silk Route trader, Munshi Aziz Bhatt. Objects on display include a variety of artifacts, including horse saddles, tapestries, utensils, coins, old manuscripts and photographs, costumes, and jewelry. Most artifacts displayed in the museum were discovered and retrieved from a rest house, that is Aksarai, currently which is dysfunctional, built in Kargil for traders in 1920 by Munshi Aziz Bhatt, and that is why it has been named after him. Here you can see some of the collections within the museum, and in the center you can see the Munshi Aziz Bhatt's photograph, and he actually got these collections from, you can, in the right side you can see the building which is looking very old. This is actually the Sarai, an inn where the traders used to halt in for the night, and they used to keep their goods there, and then they used to move towards Kashmir, or if they are going to Central Asia, and then they move to Central Asia. From there he has collected these artifacts and these heritage items, and then they have been displayed in a separate building and named as Munshi Aziz Bhatt Museum. Some of the choicest artifacts picked for exhibition include hookah pipes from Yarkand, rugs from Kashgar, fabrics which are dyed and raw silk from Khotan in China, natural dyes, costumes, jewelry, coins, shoes, utensils, and ammunition. Apart from these, the museum incorporates mercantile items from the late 19th and early 18th century, like leather skins, coarse cotton cloth, carpets from Central Asia, British horse seats and saddles, buttons from Italy, and items from the factory of Nizam of Hyderabad. So it has a diverse collection and very attractive to visit. Recently, the museum has acquired handwritten Qurans and Tibetan manuscripts, which the owners claim to be around 600 to 700 years old. And if we talk about the galleries in the museum, there are different galleries which display the different items, which include the gallery for armory, the gallery for caps and dresses, gallery for carpets, gallery for coins and currencies, gallery for daily consumer goods, horse accessory gallery, jewelry gallery, lamps and pipes, manuscripts and books gallery, painting gallery, silk items gallery, and utensils and crockery gallery. Now, talking about one more museum in the Ladakh region is Stoke House Museum. Here is the building in the display. You can see the building where the museum has been housed. So far, the Stoke Palace Museum is concerned, it is housed in royal residence and surrounding by majestic snow-capped mountains. This is actually the palace where the museum has been established, and this palace belonged to the Namgyal dynasty of Ladakh. Once they used it in the 19th century, and there also Buddhist monastery as well associated with this palace. Today it serves as a residence of royal descendants, as well as housing a museum that exhibits weapons, clothing and jewelry of past kings and queens. In this museum, there are ancient copper coins, tea kits, crowns, heirlooms, jewelries, equipments, gemstones, and items related to their traditions. It also houses sacred Dizi stones, also called pure happiness pearls, and 16th century thangkas that depict various teachings of Buddha. In this museum, you can also catch glimpses of a priceless gold crown embellished with corals, rubies, and lapis lazuli. It is still worn by the head of royal family of Ladakh on special occasions. There are also swords coupled with knot by King Tashi Fudgal for displaying his power and strength in this museum. Now, talking about one more museum in the Ladakh region is the Hall of Fame. Hall of Fame commemorates the Indian Army soldiers who lost their lives in the Indian-Pakistan wars. On the ground floor, you can gather information about the troops and learn details about their fates, as well as purchase souvenirs. On way up to the first floor, examine the exhibited war artifacts, weaponry used during combat, and important documents. The museum's display can help you imagine what high altitude battles at minus 50 degrees Celsius look like. And one can also watch a 30-minute film about the 1999 Kargil War. Talking about one more museum in Ladakh region is Balti Heritage House and Museum. Baltis are actually an ethnic group which are mostly found in Tibetan region and also Ladakh. So there is a house of Baltis who have kept a museum in that, and there are number of things which are on the display. One can find original Balti artifacts there. It is small for a museum but well kept. The building is about 140 years old house and is itself worth seeing. The location of the museum is in the narrow stone-laid lanes of the old village, which has a very calm ambience to it. Balti culture can be found in only 5 villages in India in the real form. Some of the photographs that have been taken inside the house, Balti House Museum, and the different things that are in the display are here on your screen. Most of the these displays are in the form of cloths, traditional utensils. So talking about the fifth museum in the Ladakh region is the Textile Museum of Ladakh. This museum is located in Leh, displaying extra traditional experience. The museum showcases the traditional Kashmiri, Ladakhi, and other Central Asian handloom textiles. In addition, the museum displays the beautiful traditional Persian and Kashmiri carpets and cardigans. This is best place to see the walnut wood furniture, which is the traditional furniture works there. दिस इज अ मैन मेड कार्व्ड फर्नीचर बिलोंगिंग टू एंशंट पीरियड्स और एंड मिडिवल पीरियड. वन मोर म्यूजियम दैट इज इन द रीजन ऑफ लद्दाख इज द ओल्ड रॉको हाउस एंड म्यूजियम. दिस इज द ओल्ड हाउस विद म्यूजियम, आर्ट गैलरी, ट्रेडिशनल टॉयलेट एंड अ गुड ओपन स्पेस टू रिफ्रेश योर माइंड. दिस इज अ सेंटर फॉर वर्कशॉप, योगा, सेमिनार एंड डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम्स. दिस इज अ ब्यूटिफुल ओल्ड हाउस दैट हैज बीन टर्न्ड इनटू अ कल्चरल सेंटर. दे ऑफन होल्ड वर्कशॉप्स एंड लेक्चर्स ऑन इकोलॉजी, कल्चर एंड हिस्ट्री. सो दिस इज ऑल फ्रॉम दिस साइड एंड आई होप यू वुड हैव एंजॉयड द प्रेजेंटेशन, इफ नॉट इन डिटेल. But I would like to thank for your patience. Thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you. Thanks a lot, Adilji. It's a beautiful journey of these 15 museums in Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh region. You are started, you are talking from this Amar Mahal Palace Museum and then Dogra Art Museum. It's a different type of art for all of us here. Then Kala Kendra Museum and the Natural History Museum like Wadia Museum. Then Buddhist Heritage Museum like Akhnoor. And then India's largest aquarium, Baghe Bahu. And the SPS Museum, as I know that Sir John Marshall and Dayaram Sahani helped for this museum in its first sale for its richest great collection of coins and manuscripts. Then museology courses which are available only in the museum, the Central Asian Museum. I thought that this is the only museum in this region, Jammu, Kashmir and Ladakh region. This is the only museum. Where are they with this type of courses? Then the good collection but in bad condition personal collection Miraz Mahal Museum. मेरी ये सभी से रिक्वेस्ट है, हमारे जितने भी स्कॉलर्स और यहाँ जितने भी पार्टिसिपेंट्स है, जब हम कुछ ऐसा सुनते हैं तो ऐसा लगता है कि हम लोग जो प्रोफेसर पद पर है या अलग अलग फील्ड्स में कार्य कर रहे हैं और हम लोगों को जिनको ऐसा लगता है कि म्यूजियम से एक शिक्षा के केंद्र होने चाहिए, आई रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू सिंसियरली ऐसे अपने आजू बाजू के संग्रहालयों को जो भी पॉसिबल है वो हेल्प जरूर कीजिए. अगर आप जहाँ रहते हैं वहां आजू बाजू में अगर ऐसा कोई कलेक्शन है, कोई म्यूजियम है कि जिन्होंने अपनी पूरा लाइफ जो है उसके लिए डेडिकेट किया है फॉर द कलेक्शन, क्या लगता है कलेक्शन करने के लिए जिन्होंने किया है उनसे पूछिए. अपना पूरा लाइफ यानी खाने के लिए पैसे नहीं होते मगर वो लोग जो उसके लिए अपना जीवन पूरा जो है समर्पित करते हैं क्योंकि वो एक उनका पैशन होता है. बट उसमें से हम लोग क्या शिक्षा प्राप्त कर सकते हैं, फ्यूचर जनरेशन को हम क्या बेस्ट दे सकते हैं, ये हम लोगों की जिम्मेदारी है. और हम लोग भी पूरा दिल से अगर सहयोग करें तो ऐसे शिक्षा के माध्यम, ऐसे केंद्र, हमारे प्रैक्टिकल ट्रेनिंग सेंटर्स लैब्स जो है जिसको हम कहते हैं हिस्ट्री लैब्स, ऐसा मैं उसको कहता हूँ, हिस्ट्री, आर्कियोलॉजी एंड कल्चरल लैब्स, सो दिस म्यूजियम, तो उसे जरूर मदद कीजिए. आपने बहुत अच्छा बताया आदिल जी अपने मिराज महल के बारे में, हम जरूर उसके बारे में ये करेंगे. फिर उसके बाद आपने कारगिल ट्रेड आर्टिफैक्ट्स के बारे में बताया, न्यू टाइप ऑफ म्यूजियम राकू म्यूजियम के बारे में बताया और भी कई सारे संग्रहालयों के बारे में आपने हमें बहुत अच्छी जानकारी दी. पॉसिबल तो नहीं कि हम सभी म्यूजियम्स को इस तरह विजिट कर पाए, उसमें से सिर्फ एसपी म्यूजियम या एक दो म्यूजियम्स को विजिट कर पाए. तो आपने इतना अच्छा ये कलेक्शन किया और यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कश्मीर में रहते हुए आपका ये संग्रहालयों का सफर, आपका अध्ययन जो है उसके लिए हम दिल से आपके शुक्रगुजार हैं. इफ देयर आर एनी क्वेश्चंस देन प्लीज मोस्ट वेलकम. अगर किसी के कुछ सवाल है तो जरूर पूछिए. इज देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस? I wanted to ask about funding, Garima ji. Garima ji ने ये सवाल पूछा है. Actually क्या पूछना चाहते हैं आप funding के बारे में, क्योंकि funding तो दो अलग अलग तरह से होते हैं. एक तो government के स्तर पर जो funding होता है और जो दूसरे private fundings होते हैं, जैसे कोई CSR funding हो या फिर कोई personal donors हो, तो इस तरह के अलग अलग funding. Is it easy to get funding for this museum from the government? गवर्नमेंट की आज की जो जो प्रावधान है संग्रहालयों को फंड देने की, वो अलग तरह से है। या तो अभी वैसे देखा जाए तो पूरे भारत के जितने संग्रहालयों के लिए जो फंडिंग प्राप्त होता है, क्योंकि फंडिंग का जो स्ट्रक्चर अभी तक हमने अध्ययन किया है, मैं वैसे हमारे यहाँ की जिन जिन कमेटियों का मेंबर भी हूँ, तो हम ये देखते हैं कि उसके लिए बहुत प्रॉपर रूप से आपका पूरा ये प्लान बनना चाहिए, प्रपोजल बनना चाहिए, आपकी कमेटी किस तरह की है, फॉलो अप किस तरह से लेते हैं, स्पेशली सिंस द स्टेट हैज बीन चेंज्ड इनटू टू यूनियन टेरिटरीज, नॉट ओनली आफ्टर द यूनियन टेरिटरीज बट बिफोर ऑफ दैट आल्सो। अभी तक जम्मू कश्मीर रीजन हो या फिर ओवरऑल इंडिया के भी सिर्फ स्टेट म्यूजियम्स को अगर छोड़ा जाए, स्टेट म्यूजियम्स एंड सम ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट म्यूजियम्स ओनली, फंडिंग की सिचुएशन पूरे इंडिया केस में अभी तक प्रॉपर नहीं है। ओनली द प्राइवेट म्यूजियम्स और द इंडस्ट्रियल म्यूजियम्स जिनको CSR फंडिंग्स अवेलेबल है, दे आर इन गुड कंडीशन, एंड फ्यू स्टेट म्यूजियम्स लाइक द भुवनेश्वर म्यूजियम, भुवनेश्वर स्टेट म्यूजियम और सम इन लखनऊ लाइक दैट, उनकी कंडीशन है नेशनल म्यूजियम्स, तो उनको ही फंडिंग प्राप्त है। अभी भी डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल म्यूजियम्स एंड अदर ऑल द म्यूजियम्स, उनको फंडिंग ठीक तरह से प्राप्त नहीं होता है। इसका कारण मैं ये बता रहा हूँ कि उसके लिए जो प्रावधान हमारे बजट में होता है वो बहुत कम होता है, और दूसरी बात जो प्रपोजल जिस तरह से भेजे जाते हैं, अभी हमने देखा कि महाराष्ट्र में लास्ट ईयर में सिर्फ दो म्यूजियम के लिए प्रपोजल आए थे, और उसमें भी जो प्रपोजल आए वो ठीक तरह से नहीं ये किए गए थे, तो यानी उसका फॉर्म जो है वो ठीक तरह से या उसका डाटा जो देना चाहिए वो ठीक तरह से नहीं दिया गया था। सो ये सिचुएशन है ओवरऑल इंडिया में, नॉट ओनली इन जम्मू कश्मीर बट इन ऑल ओवर द इंडिया। इज देर एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस? मुझे क्षमा करना अब्दुल अदील जी, मैंने ही सवाल का जवाब दे दिया। आई एम वेरी
थैंक यू सर,
सॉरी।
थैंक यू सर, मुझे पता नहीं इतना सर, आपने अच्छा किया, थैंक यू सो
थैंक
मच।
यू। अगर सवाल है पराग जी। थैंक
हेलो, हाँ अदिल जी, बहुत थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर अ
यू
नाइस
सर,
प्रेजेंटेशन।
थैंक
एक
यू सर।
सवाल है कि वहाँ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट जोन का असर हेरिटेज पर जो म्यूजियम्स और आर्टिफैक्ट्स जो रखे उसके ऊपर क्या होता है क्या?
यस सर, सर एक्चुअली अगर हम देखेंगे कि ये जो कन्फ्लिक्ट जोन बनने की वजह से जो सबसे ज़्यादा नुकसान हुआ है दैट इज हेरिटेज हैज़ सफर्ड अ लॉट, क्योंकि ये एक ऐसा फील्ड है जो मतलब जिससे कोई कुछ हासिल नहीं कर सकता डायरेक्टली, जो कोई कमा नहीं सकता, नो वन इज एसोसिएटेड डायरेक्टली फॉर इट्स सब्सिस्टेंस टू द टू इट, और वी कैन से दैट हेरिटेज डजेंट गिव डायरेक्टली मनी टू द पीपल और अर्निंग हैंड टू द पीपल। दैट इज वाई एक तो लोगों का अटेंशन इसके साथ इतना है ही नहीं इस रीजन में, मतलब है अब कुछ मतलब जो नए स्कॉलर्स हैं, नए हिस्टोरियंस हैं, उनका है कि मतलब वो अपनी आइडेंटिटी को प्रिजर्व करना चाहते हैं। लेकिन सबसे मेन बात जो चीज जो अभी बोबड़े सर बोल रहे थे कि फंडिंग होनी चाहिए, ऐसे मैनेजर्स होने चाहिए, ऐसे डायरेक्टर्स होने चाहिए हु हैव कंसर्न एंड दे शुड हैव कंसर्न बाय हार्ट। उनको ये लगना चाहिए कि नहीं, दिस इज आवर हेरिटेज, दिस इज आवर आइडेंटिटी एंड वी शुड प्रिजर्व इट, वी शुड कीप इट फॉर द फ्यूचर। ऐसे लोग जो हैं वो मैं यही कहूंगा कि सिर्फ कश्मीर में नहीं बल्कि कश्मीर से बाहर भी, क्योंकि इसका असर दुगना हुआ जब यहाँ कन्फ्लिक्ट हुआ, क्योंकि कन्फ्लिक्ट में ये ऐसा होता है कि लोग सिर्फ उन चीजों के साथ रिलेटेड रहते हैं जिनसे उनका फायदा हो, और हेरिटेज एक ऐसा मामला है जिससे लोगों का डायरेक्टली कोई, हाँ ये बात सच है कि टूरिस्ट जो हैं जो दे विजिट द दीज साइट्स नाउ एंड पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग अबाउट इट दैट नो वी शुड प्रिजर्व, वी शुड कीप दीज साइट्स सेफ फॉर द फ्यूचर, बट दे स्टिल रिक्वायर मोर फंड्स फॉर देयर रेस्टोरेशन, फॉर देयर रिपेयरमेंट एंड अदर थिंग्स। इसलिए जो सबसे ज्यादा असर हुआ है वो ये है कि इस कंफ्लिक्ट से हेरिटेज को हुआ है, हेरिटेज को नुकसान हुआ है। यू आर राइट सर दैट कि हेरिटेज पे इतना ध्यान नहीं दिया गया है, चाहे वो कंसर्न डिपार्टमेंट्स हो या फिर लोग हो इनिशियली। अब लोगों का तो बढ़ रहा है इसकी तरफ रुझान, लेकिन पहले पहले नहीं था। होप आई हैव आंसर्ड क्वेश्चन। थैंक
यू विक्रम जी। यहाँ पूछिए विक्रम भारद्वाज जी। विक्रम जी कुछ आप पूछना चाहते हैं?
हेलो, नमस्कार,
हाँ
मेरी
यस
आवाज आ रही
यस
है सर? आई वांट टू सिनेरियो ऑफ द शिकारा एज फॉर द बोट होटल्स, वेदर दे आर कंसीडर्ड एज हेरिटेज ऑफ कश्मीर और फॉर दे हैव लॉस्ट द सिग्निफिकेंस इन दिस कॉन्फ्लिक्ट एरा।
यस सर, एक्चुअली आई हैड टॉक्ड ओनली अबाउट द म्यूजियम्स, बट सिंस शिकारास जो हैं, शिकारास दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द म्यूजियम सॉरी हेरिटेज इन कश्मीर, बिकॉज दे आर पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ द पीपल हु आर एसोसिएटेड विद इट फॉर देयर सबसिस्टेंस, फॉर अर्निंग देयर लाइफ, एज वेल एज दे डिस्प्ले अ वेरी डिफरेंट एंड ब्यूटिफुल फेस ऑफ कश्मीर विच इज यूनिक इन द इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट. That is why they have a heritage character, no doubt in it, but there should be done more to boost that very area so that the old Shikara should be kept in at a particular place. Their architecture should be maintained. That should be keep for the future generations, because since new hotels, three-star, five-star hotels are, they have come up in the region. So most of the people, they prefer to live in those hotels and there is very much less attention towards the shikaras. But of course, shikaras are very much part of, very much important part of, significant part of the heritage of Kashmir.
So at the same time, I want to ask one more thing. Kashmir, yes, woodwork is very important. Further, the specifically the woodwork on akhrot wood is very important. And I have seen best furniture from this particular area. Whether they are also considered as a heritage or again, further in the modernized era, whether people are losing their interest in those particular architectural heritage. Further the heritage of...
Of course, sir. Thank you, sir. Actually, most of the museums now... They are displaying the woodworks which is in the on the walnut wood. They are keeping it as they in their displays in the museums presently. But the old craftsmen who were associated with that craft, they have also lost their because they some of them have not lived. They have passed away. The next generation they are moving towards the other occupations and other jobs. So the craftsmen who are associated with the woodwork, particularly the walnut woodwork, they are the works are now going on very slow pace, and very little work is going so far the woodwork is concerned. But the old woodwork have been preserved. They are being kept by the Department of Archaeology and Archives in the different museums and the displays also. But the profession is not continue. The craftsmanship is that has come to halt because new generations are not so much enthusiastic about the woodwork. So you are right, sir, that is a very important part of the heritage in the Kashmir woodwork, but craftsmanship has lost. That's it.
So if chair permits me, I want to ask another question, a small one.
Sure, sir.
Bajang sir permits me.
Yes, sir.
Ikor, I want to one more thing. Further, you were talking about Dogra Museum and Dogra heritage. Further, yes, when we talk about Dogras, we have Dogras in Himachal also. A big particular area in Himachal, further called, people call themselves good Dogras, whether we talk about Chamba, whether we talk about further Kangra. Whether there are artifacts of this region in those particular museums?
Of course, sir. Actually, the Kangra and Jammu region, they are very much close geographically as well. And that is why I talked about the Kangra and Basholi paintings. That is part and parcel of both the regions because they are associated with it. And the people living in the hilly regions of Kangra and this Jammu region as well as Kashmir region, they have a close connection between each other. And that is why there are a mixed, a particular culture associated with these regions. Because this geographically, we cannot isolate them. We cannot keep them away from each other. And that is why their culture is also associated with each other. And they have there are displays of Kangra paintings, Basholi paintings, and other traditional attires of the region. They are in the museums. So we cannot isolate them. We cannot keep them away from each other because they are geographically as well as culturally, they are associated and connected with each other.
One more, sir. Jammu have a language earlier which is Nomo. For the very few people know about that particular language, and it is slowly and slowly dying. I have forgotten the name of that particular language.
Is it the language or the script?
Yeah, it is the language of the script. I have forgotten the name of that.
Is it the Sharda?
Yes, Sharda script. Further, where in which particular museum you have mixed manuscripts of Sharda?
Actually, sir, I don't know about
SP Museum.
Sorry for it.
Yeah, this collection. As I know, my best information regarding this is SP Museum have the best collection of the Sharda script, and in National Museum Delhi also, National Archives have also the best collection of this Sharda manuscripts. And Dr. Trilokinath Ganju is the person जो उसके व्याकरण के बहुत अच्छे अभ्यासक है, ग्रामर और सभी का अच्छा अध्ययन है उनका, और उन्होंने हमें 21 दिन तक शारदा स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ाई थी व्हेन आई वाज वर्किंग एज द डायरेक्टर फॉर मैनुस्क्रिप्ट डिपार्टमेंट इन हैदराबाद.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक
यू सर. थैंक यू. नमस्कार सर. नमस्कार. धन्यवाद.
यस. थैंक यू. थैंक्स अ लॉट अगेन. यहाँ पर अभी दूसरे किसी के सवाल नहीं दिखाई दे रहे. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग द म्यूजियम्स इन जम्मू कश्मीर एंड लेह लद्दाख रीजन, देन यू कैन सेंड इट ऑन व्हाट्सएप आल्सो. सो अब्दुल अदील जी, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. आपने बहुत अच्छी जानकारी हम सभी को दी और बहुत अच्छे आपने ये सभी सवालों में से भी जो जानकारी हमें हमारे लिए दी उसके लिए भी आपका बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया. एंड विथ योर काइंड परमिशन नाउ वी विल स्टॉप हियर.
Thank you so much for this opportunity. Thank you so much. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Jay. Okay.